I like Azure AD Domain Services. I really do. But I have realized that not everyone shares that opinion. There's a lot of blog posts, forum threads, and videos out there warning against this service. So I thought I'd make this video describing, first of all, what the service does and how it works, but also why and in which case I like to use it, and why I think a lot of people are hating on this service. So yeah, let's get to it, I guess. First things first, if you have the impression that Azure AD Domain Services can do everything that a traditional Active Directory can, then sorry, it just can't. So that means that if you already have your traditional Active Directory complete with AD Connect and so on, and are planning to replace it completely with Azure AD Domain Services, well, then you might have to reevaluate that plan. But let's get back to basics. What is this service that so many are hating on? Well, at its core, Azure AD Domain Services aims to provide you with most of the feature set that Active Directory has, but as a fully managed service and synchronized from Azure AD. What you get when you deploy Azure AD Domain Services is, in essence, two domain controllers that are fully managed by Microsoft. You actually don't even see these VMs in your Azure tenants. All you see is their network cards and a load balancer that's placed in front of them. And of course, the Azure AD Domain Services service itself. With this, you get what might look like a traditional Active Directory. You have the ability to join service and computers to the domain, use NTLM and Kerberos for authentication, configure group policies, use LDAP, secure LDAP, and so on. You can also use familiar tools like Active Directory users computers, group policy management, and so on. The two domain controllers you get make up what Microsoft refers to as a replica set, and the two are deployed in different availability zones if the region you are deploying in has support for that. But they are deployed in a single subnet, and that last bit there also means that the service is bound to that one VNet, and by extent, only one single region. If you want to, you can create additional replica sets in any region you want, but then you would also need to upgrade from the standard SKU to either Premium or Enterprise. This upgrade also gives you access to a couple more features, like creating trusts, of course with the additional cost. Azure AD Domain Services is priced per hour per replica set, so if you upgrade to Premium and max out the number of replica sets, which would be 5, then the costs can rack up quite rapidly. But if all you need is the standard version, well, then it's really not that expensive given what you get. So that's the basics of Azure AD Domain Services, what it is, and a simplified explanation of how it works. I said in the beginning of the video that I like this service, and I do, but it's definitely not for everyone and every use case. My first encounter with the service was back when Windows Virtual Desktop, now named Azure Virtual Desktop, was in public preview. Back then, I worked at a company that was pretty much cloud only. We didn't have an on-prem Active Directory, so naturally we didn't have AD Connect either. Which all worked great, but then I pitched in Azure Virtual Desktop and that we should give it a try. And back then, AVD didn't support Azure AD joint session hosts. You had to have a traditional Active Directory type of service that was in sync with Azure AD. Since we didn't want the hassle of setting up a domain controller in Azure and configuring AD Connect, messing with our pure and beautiful Azure AD, just for this one test of a service, Azure AD Domain Services was the rescue for us. Or at least for me, since I was the one wanting to try this out in a, you know, real world scenario. And that's probably my favorite use case for Azure AD Domain Services. Scenarios where you already are all cloud and happy with just Azure AD. Then some need arises for a traditional Active Directory. In those cases, you have Azure AD as the source of truth for all your user accounts, but the second you set up Active Directory with AD Connect and start synchronizing user accounts, that shifts to Active Directory being the source of truth. And then it also becomes a hassle if that need for traditional Active Directory goes away and you want to get rid of that AD and AD Connect. But the beauty of Azure AD Domain Services is that it synchronizes from Azure AD, and it does so without any connectors or agents. It just works. And when you remove the service, there's no missing synchronization stuff left in Azure AD. It's just as plain as beautiful as it was before you deployed Azure AD Domain Services. Another kind of cool use case for Azure AD Domain Services is if you're transitioning from an on-prem kind of setup to an all-cloud, but you still have a small number of legacy apps or services that require traditional Active Directory. In this case, you probably already have AD Connect and are syncing your users from on-prem to Azure AD. Now what you can do is to set up Azure AD Domain Services in your Azure environment and have it running side by side your on-prem. Then you migrate all that can be all cloud, and for those that cannot, you place them with Azure AD Domain Services and tie them to that Active Directory instead. Then you can cut cord with your on-prem, and when those legacy apps are gone, you can just delete Azure AD Domain Services. When it comes to people hating on Azure AD's domain services, that's mostly because of its limitations, because there are quite a few of them. But it's also a case of setting your expectations. If you expect Azure AD domain services to be Active Directory as a service, you will be disappointed. Like I said earlier, Azure AD domain services cannot do everything that Active Directory can. But just so you don't get disappointed, let's discuss the limitations that Azure AD domain services has. First of all, it doesn't have any connection to any existing Active Directory you have, so it's not a simple way to just extend your Active Directory to Azure. You can sync users from Active Directory to Azure AD and then down to Azure AD Domain Services, but that's it. You also don't get full permissions to the Active Directory that Azure AD Domain Services provide. That's right, you don't even get domain admin permissions, and no enterprise admin and no schema admin. And no schema admin also means no way to extend the schema. So if you're looking to set up Exchange or any other service that requires extension of the schema, you cannot use Azure AD Domain Services. And no enterprise admin also means no way of setting up Active Directory certificate services. So your plans of combining Azure AD Domain Services with certificate-based features can all be tossed away. Another limitation, and this one is sadly a big one for me, is the lack of support for hybrid joining. This might not affect you, but things like MSIX App Attach and Universal Print requires hybrid joining, so no go on the Azure AD Domain Services if you plan on using those. You also are limited to only one Azure AD Domain Services per Azure AD tenant. Like mentioned, you can create multiple replica sets, but those will only be replicas of that first instance. So when you create your Azure AD Domain Services, plan accordingly. You should plan for Azure AD Domain Services being used by many different services, not just one. If you keep these limitations in mind when you plan for your usage of Azure AD Domain Services, I don't think you will be disappointed with this service. Like I said at the start of the video, I like Azure AD Domain Services, but it's just not for every use case out there. But one thing that it certainly can be used for is Azure Virtual Desktop. If you're new to that service, then you might be interested in this video where I cover just what AVD is and how it works. Thanks for watching!